Hey everyone, this is Patrice with the Positivity Corner, and I am back with some more reaction videos. I've been really enjoying this lately. I don't know if it's because I'm stuck in the house like you are, or I think it's really because of the music that I'm playing. It just brings back so many memories and it's good music too, on top of everything else. When I did my little snippet of Motown, there were many people that I left out. Stevie Wonder's a big one. I'm gonna have to do a deep dive into him. I'm not gonna do as many videos with him as I did for the Beatles, but it'll be more than two or four for sure. I didn't get a chance to talk about this group. However, I'm not gonna do all their songs on Motown because eventually they left and went to, I think it was Buddha Records at one point. They left Motown. And I'm gonna do a couple of the post-Motown ones too. They are one of the best vocal groups you will ever hear. I mean, what can he say about them? I'm talking about Gladys Knight and the Pips. Ooh-wee. Those Pips, they could blow. And of course, the iconic, legendary Gladys Knight, who started singing when she was a kid early on. They got together in 1952. They stayed together until 19, I think, 89. Wow, what a group. As I said, some of the best vocals you will ever hear. The Pips, their harmonies, top notch. And of course, Gladys, that voice. Nobody sounds like her. You know, she's up in years now, but she could still blow. If you saw any excerpts from the Queen of Soul, Aretha Franklin's funeral, watch that one with Gladys Knight, honey. She brought the house down. She could still blow. Ooh, if you ever see her in person, of course she's had a glorious solo career, but she still sings the old stuff too, which is fantastic. Highly recommend it. She's great. As I said, they started out in 1952. Gladys had been singing for years up at that point. She had been on, I think the Ted Mack Amateur Hour and all that kind of stuff when she was a kid. They had several record deals. Nothing really happened. Fast forward. They had one hit in the late 50s, Every Beat of My Heart. They changed the name because originally they were the Pips, then they changed it to Gladys Knight and the Pips in 1961. Fast forward, 1966. They signed with Berry Gordy and Motown Records. And the rest is history. I'm gonna play this first one. It took a year and a half, though, for them to get to this point, right? They signed with them in 1966. This song was huge. It was a huge hit. But before Gladys Knight and the Pips sang it, the Miracles had it first. They first recorded it. This went, but Gladys Knight and the Pips, their version It went to number two on the Billboard pop singles chart rather. And up until that point, because we're talking 1967, it became the biggest selling single to date at that point that Motown had. I mean, it was a big hit. It's totally different from the next version, which is on my channel, right? That's the Marvin Gaye version. I'm talking about I Heard It Through the Grapevine. Gladys Knight's version is fast. Marvin Gaye's version is more like a mid-tempo. Different. Just different. But you know what? They're both really, really good. And I'm telling you, I remember when this came out. We loved it. We absolutely loved it. This is Gladys Knight and the Pips with the iconic Motown classic, I Heard It Through the Grapevine, from 1967. It sold 2 million copies. Mm-hmm. That really put them up in the Motown hierarchy, because Gladys had been complaining that they were getting the leftovers and that they were down on the totem pole behind, you know, Diana Ross and Supremes, Marvin Gaye, whatever, yada, yada, yada. This kind of gave them a little more clout, and they began to get you know, better production and better songwriters, particularly Norman Whitfield, who did all those massive hits with the Temptations. I love that version. I love the Marvin Gaye version. You know, it's kind of like, what is it? Oh, when I did Diana Ross, right? Ain't No Mountain High Enough. I love both versions of that too. I mean, I love the Marvin Gaye, Tammy Terrell, and I love the Diana Ross. They're just both different. And I think it's the same thing with this. I think there's room for both. Marvin Gaye, of course, had the bigger hit. His sold 4 million copies. But hey, I mean, it's the luck of the draw, right? In any case, a great, great tune from Gladys Knight and the Pips, 1967. I heard it through the grapevine. Good stuff. As always, this is the Positivity Corner with Patrice. Please like, click, share, subscribe for further content. And I will be back with another one from Gladys Knight and the Pips.